don't know if he handed it off. He tricked me.
Supposed to be an RPO. I think he missed the initial handoff.
Stuart Ross, I believe, the quarterback. 18, yep, Stuart Ross is the new quarterback for St. Xavier, the freshman out of Springfield Southeast.
Well, we thought early in the ball game that people were going to move around, and they certainly have.
Yes, sir. Third down and long to go. Third down and 16 yards. McShane in motion. Check it down to him, but it's thrown into the ground. Was it a backward pass or was it not? They did not blow the whistle,
no,
so it was a fumble technically.
That looked like a forward pass to me, but the side judge didn't make a signal, so they called that a lateral. That means the clock should still be running.
And it is under 5 minutes here. Brings up fourth down. You can tell they're excited to play on both sides. The energy is very high. Still knocking off a lot of rust. Kyle Hassert, the punter for St. Xavier, standing in his own end zone.
We still only have 10 guys on the field.
High punt, sending the return man back past the 50.
Oh!
Makes one man miss to Multi, back toward the middle of the field. He's got a couple blockers in front of him. To the outside, 10, 5. Touchdown, the first score of the season for St. Francis on a punt return.
We talked about that, didn't we?
Nailed it again.
Any chance you get to return a kick, return it, because coverage has not been practiced as much as it should be. He zigged, he zagged, he went left, he went right. That's an outstanding job.
And the setup for the extra point. I'm still working on pronunciations for our new guy, so I apologize if I don't get his name right, but Scott Tumulati. I know Dave is going to correct me on that.
Just call Scott T.
Scotty T? All right, I'm fine with it. I apologize. Some miscommunication on the extra point, just like you were saying. Special teams is going to be an issue, and a timeout called, and Coach
again,
Curry
again, we had 10 players on the field.
Unhappy.
You, after this game is over, I'm going right to the sports book. I'm like, what, 4 for 4 today on nailing stuff.
Officials are going to discuss a couple of things here as well, probably about the formation. But we've seen that from St. Francis in years past.
That's called swinging gate formation. You take all your linemen, put them over to the numbers or the hash. They've got to defend it. Usually sets up a two-point play later or something that other teams will have to spend practice time defending and going over.
And they're going to set up for the traditional point after kick.
Now speaking of that, do you know that one of the prop bets for the Super Bowl tomorrow is you can actually bet if a kick is going to hit an upright or not. Not miss or go
just
in,
hit.
But hit an upright.
I feel like that's a Chicago Bears bet. I just can't, you know, the double doink will reign in infamy, and I can't not get it out of my brain. Brian Bidet, the freshman kicker, to take the lead if it goes through.
Oh.
It's low. It's a line drive. Did it sneak through? It
no.
did not. Wide left. So we're tied at 6 here in Joliet. 4:18 to go here first quarter. St. Francis and St. Xavier for the 22nd time. St. Francis just 1-2. Their only win was back in, what was that, a couple years ago. 24-21 was the victory for St. Francis. Playing St. Xavier for the third time in their last 5 games. It's kind of crazy how the schedules worked out. They only played St. Xavier twice last year because Lindenwood Belleville dropped their program. They had a hole in their schedule, so they played St. Xavier.
I know,
again.
And I talked to Mr. Laquetta, who is the fine athletic director here, and I said,
"Call
I
him out.
I know you got a lot on your plate, Dave, you know, but really, let me take over the scheduling, because I guarantee you, boys and girls, we would have been somewhere like in Florida. You know, we would have played Florida State. I don't care who we would have played, but, you know, to open up, I'm just glad we're playing, but."
Yep. Madey on to kick it off. 4:18 to go first quarter. We're tied at 6. Low angle kick sends the return man back to the 10. Here comes Quay Thompson on
that
the return.
Boy.
Wrapped up at the 21-yard line. Rayvon Johnson, the wide receiver, highly touted, coming in and making a special teams tackle.
Now, what does that speak of when you put your best wide receiver on your kickoff return team? That means you value that. You just haven't had enough practice time or rep time to get, hey, make sure you stay in your lane, make sure we're going to kick it to this hash mark, we're going to kick it to this hash mark. That'll come, though.
O'Sullivan back in at quarterback for St. Xavier. McShane on his left hip. Four wide receivers spread over the field. Screen it out for a wide receiver. It's caught. Here's Ludeman. Unable to evade the tacklers for too long. To the 29 he goes. He'll pick up about six.
And it sounds simple, but Ludeman did a great job of catching that football with his hands. So many times receivers, especially in the cold conditions, they'll want to catch it with their body, but he did a nice job catching with his hands.
Motion to McShane. He's hitting the backfield, but still on his feet. Bust to the outside with the secondary tackle there to take him down. Still behind the line of scrimmage. Jutting in is Chris Peters, the returning defensive end for St. Francis on the initial hit.
He blew up that play. He knifed down.
Chris is a big boy, too. 6'4", 255, just in great shape. Very quick out of Lincoln Way North. O'Sullivan again. Finds Ludeman right at the first down line, and he's able to move the chains. Ludeman last year, 21 catches, 209 yards, and one touchdown. They've pretty much lost all of their wide receiver production from last year, St. Xavier has. And Harold Davis and Nick Krzyzewski and Chris Simmons, their top three wide receivers last year, now gone. So they got a new crop of skilled guys, too, on the offensive side of the ball. Motion again. Play action this time. Sullivan, plenty of time. Fires in.
Oh!
It is caught by St. Xavier and past the 50 into St. Francis territory. I think some of us thought that was going to be picked off by Scott Tumulty, Scotty T.
Well, he does a nice job breaking on the ball. The only thing he didn't do is come up with the interception.
I apologize to his family. I got to get that name right before halftime. Another check down by St. Xavier. Ludeman again, and I don't think St. Francis was near ready for the play. 2 minutes and 20 seconds to go here, first quarter. We're tied at six.
This seems like the longest first quarter, or maybe just because we haven't done a football game forever.
Yeah, right. St. Xavier on the hurry up, though. McShane on the sweep. No room there. He'll pick up maybe two. Past the 40-yard line. Brings up third down for the Cougars. 2 minutes to go in the first. Third down here for the Cougars. He'll pass it left again, and they got a blocker in front and another first down for Pringle. Two touchdowns by each team. St. Xavier first on the board with a 56-yard run by Vance McShane. St. Francis waited a few possessions but answered back with a punt return touchdown by Scotty T. And that's how we got to our 6-6 score. Blitz here by St. Francis. They run right at it, but there goes DQ Smith. Past the 10 and tripped up at the 5.
He just ran it right into the teeth of where we were blitzing, caught it on a B gap, took it down the left hash mark, almost went all the way in.
Again, hurrying to the line, O'Sullivan in the offense for the Cougars. He's looking into the end zone, launches one into the back corner and into the snowdrift, incomplete. Believe he was looking for Brant Hickson, but he might have just thrown that one away. Everyone was pretty well covered. 63 seconds to go. Timeout called by the Cougars. Take a quick look at the schedule for this season. Two home games to start things off for St. Francis. Next week, they will host the newly formed Roosevelt University football team as they combined with Robert Morris. Pretty much the Robert Morris football team changing jerseys, essentially. Roosevelt did not have a football program, so they're going to combine universities, combine football programs, and we will see them next week here at the stadium, hopefully under slightly better conditions. St. Ambrose, the first road game for St. Francis. That'll be week 3 out in Davenport, Iowa. And then it's the Lakers of Roosevelt again up in Chicago. And then out to Bourbonnais for Olivet Nazarene to cap off that three-game road trip. Next home game after today, or after next week, I should say, will be Trinity International in March, on March 20th. And then it's Missouri Baptist, St. Ambrose again, and then St. Xavier again. Keeping everything as local as possible on the schedule. Second down and goal for the Cougars here with 63 seconds to go in the first quarter. O'Sullivan, the redshirt freshman quarterback. DQ Smith on his left shoulder. Four wide receivers, Pringle in motion. He'll go left side,
nice
trip
play
behind the line of scrimmage. And it's Chris Peters putting his big paw out there to knock him down.
He pushed him upfield. He kept outside leverage. Got him with his right arm just enough to get him on the ground.
Third down and goal back at the 9-yard line for the Cougars now. O'Sullivan to throw. Here comes pressure. Hit as he's thrown. Caught at the 5. Pringle is finally wrapped down after some help. Initial stop there for St. Francis. I believe that was Rio.
Cougars looks like they're going for the field goal, and that's not a sure thing, especially even from the 5-yard line.
It was Jalen Cooper on the tackle, but Mike Iturbe has been as steady as you can be, a kicker for St. Xavier in his 3 years here. 5 seconds to go in the quarter. Kick is up, and it is good. 9-6 will be our score, but we do have 2 more seconds, so they will have to kick it off here. But like you said, Coach, anything can happen on special teams today.
Kind of reminds me of playing football when you're a kid. And I don't know if you did, you know, snow dust. Hey, we got to go play football. And you shovel off a little something, you just have a little patch of grass, and you play it outside.
But you mentioned it in the pregame here. Shout out to the Joliet Park District, who, without them, this game would not be playing today. We did have about a foot of snow a few days ago. So they were out here yesterday plowing, getting the snow off the field, and actually the turf in pretty good shape. So this game does not happen without the hard work of the Joliet Park District, so we thank them for that. That drive for St. Xavier goes 12 plays for 72 yards, takes up 4 minutes and 11 seconds. And you were down on the field. The turf
is
pretty
fine.
Good.
It's fine. Can't complain.
And that's what I think what the big worry was. How much ice was going to be under that snow? Is there going to be ice on the field? And a couple patches here and there, but all in all, pretty good shape. That's why you put in the field turf, Coach.
For all the games that are played here on this field between youth, high school, and college, that's a good investment.
1.8 seconds to go, so the return will take us to the end of the quarter. Scotty at the 10-yard line. See what happens here. He already returned a punt for a touchdown. Breaks one, breaks two tackles. He's got a nice seam up the right sideline. He's folded down at the 40-yard line, and that is where St. Francis will take over when we start quarter number two.
You'd have to say that St. Francis had excellent starting position for all their drives here in the first quarter so far. I'd really like to see, going into the second quarter, Pierre Barberin start to establish himself a little bit.
Yeah.
Maybe he'll get him some more touches going in there. And it looks like St. Xavier has done a good job. Hey, we're not going to let you get comfortable. We're going to blitz you. We're going to move people. We're going to bring people from different points, different launch points.
He talked about feminists in his time here at St. Francis back in 1989 is when he won that defensive MVP for the NAIA, of course, under head coach Gordy Gillespie. A legend here in Joliet, coaching multiple sports at multiple levels. And actually, with Joe Curry here being his 9th season at the helm of the Saints, he surpasses Gordy Gillespie in years coached here at St. Francis. Gordy coached for 8 years, starting the program back in the 80s. But it's Mike Slovic who's coached here the longest. He has 11 years under his belt.
Well, it wouldn't be a football game without Mr. Laqueta dropping down some first quarter stats, which we'll go over after this play.
St. Francis will start the second quarter here at their own 40-yard line. Blitz coming from left side of the quarterback. They're going to hand it off. Cut back right up the middle. Nice run for St. Francis. Best run so far of the game. And that's going to be a first down, a pickup of 11 for Keenan Haley.
Real quick, the thing that pops off the page on the first quarter stats is the offense. Total plays for St. X, 28 for 175. St. Francis only ran 8 plays for 10 yards in the first quarter.
Play action. Matthew's going to keep it. Not much of a runner. He was looking out to throw that out to his receiver, Liam Eldridge, but Liam was going out to block. There was some miscommunication on the play call there. And Maffey smartly didn't throw it. He just kind of tucked it in and got what he could get. Keenan Haley, the running back, on his right hip. Again, 2 wideouts right, 1 to the left here on 2nd down and 8. The give to Haley. He's got a nice hole spinning toward the 40-yard line, but he's hit at the 42. It's going to be 3rd down and 3 coming up for the Saints. Tough running by Keenan Haley. Transfer from Quincy. JCA product here in Joliet. Some more blitzing by the Cougars. Hand off to Haley. But he makes a miss, and he picks up another tough first down for the Saints. Picks up 4, and he needed 3. First down, move the chains. St. Francis doing it on the ground now.
And picking up the tempo.
Fake. Across the middle, nearly intercepted, and we got a hurt arm. Yeah, his arm hit the helmet of the defensive back, Dan Getch did. He's going to run it back, but, man, he looks like he is in some pain. Got a flag on the field, too.
That's usually an area of holding, and that's what they're going to call.
Another notch in your column there, Coach.
I'm just saying, you could just tell, and you try to watch the mechanics of the officials and see if they're looking where they're supposed to be. Now it makes it 1st and 20.
Changes the game plan a little bit here. 13:30 to go. We're just underway here in quarter number 2. Maffey is looking for some kind of pre-snap movement, but they're not on the same page here. Maffey takes the snap, hands off to Haley. Another inside run, another great block inside, and he'll pick up 11 or 12 on the play. How about Keenan Haley here in the second quarter?
He is not listed as real big guy.
Oh, but he hurt his foot. Parade Barberin's going to trot on. Dan Getch still in some visible pain there at the tight end on the left side of that line. 2nd down and 8. The give to Barberin. He needs to turn down the Jets here. We'll pick up 2 on the play.
All the running backs I've ever known, they always want to bounce it outside. Take it up the middle, take your 3 or 4 yards, and then once you get past the first level, then you can bounce it outside.
Come on, Corin now. Another running back, 3rd running back we've seen today so far as we hold tryouts apparently. 3rd down and 5. Here's Maffey looking to throw.
Nice
down
catch.
The middle, it's caught inside the 25-yard line, and another St. Francis first down, overcoming the holding penalty earlier on.
I like what St. Francis is doing here in terms of tempo with their offense.
Keep an eye for Ravon Johnson, top of your screen left. High snap, handled, handoff. Corin to the 18-yard line. Pick up a 5 on that play.
Corin and Haley strike me as the same type of back in terms of stature and what they do with the football.
Two safeties in. Here come the blitz from the outside linebackers. They're going to have to hurry, hand off, and they got them. Put a flag on that play. Did they cross too early, or was there a...
That looks like it's offsides. The line judge called that one.
As it sits, 2nd and 5, I'm going to say no gain on the play, but we believe that penalty to be against the Cougars. Let's see what the officials have to say. No, they're going to call it on the Saints, false start. Saw that blitz coming and jumped a bit too early. So take second and five, make it second and 10. Knocking on the door of the red zone here are the Saints. Jet motion. Maffey's going to keep it. Puts his head down up to the 17-yard line. He'll pick up six on the play.
That was supposed to be a fake.
Did you say that? But you just see a hole here or what?
He saw a hole there, and then he was supposed to hand it off, and the guy who was supposed to take the ball said, no, I think I'm supposed to get it. He said, no, I'll take this one.
It did seem to be a little bit of miscommunication, but worked out for the Saints that time. Third and four here. They've done it on the ground mostly, but a couple nice passes as well. Motion, fake, looking to throw, and hit as he's thrown, incomplete. Just getting there in time for St. Xavier, 93, Jaden Chandler, the sophomore defensive end. And that will bring up fourth down. Offense will go off the field, and Made will set up for his first field goal attempt as a college kicker. It'll be a 34-yard attempt from the right hash. Winds are calm here in Joliet at the moment. Kick, their snap is good. Hold is down. Kick has plenty of leg, and it is good. Brian Made, congratulations, young man. One for one here for the Saints, and that pulls the game to a tie again. 9-9 with 11:04 to go in the first half.
Now, see, we know it's the first game because the ball boy didn't go behind the goalpost to retrieve the ball. It went into a snowdrift, so there are two officials who were back by the goalpost who were supposed to signal if it's good or not. They said, the ball's in a snowdrift. We're not going to go get it.
So now there's
an innocent guy, bystander, coming over now, retrieving the ball, flipping over the big, huge snowdrift.
Coach Lee Turnbow with your play-by-play.
Oh, mechanics.
Thank everyone watching on the USF Sports TV network, especially on our YouTube live stream. Whether you're a Saints fan or Cougar fan, nice to have you here.
And I will say our social distancing placard, I think I had to go on concussion protocol because when that fell earlier, it smacked me on my head.
Kick, sidewinder, angle left. The return will be McShane, I believe, from the 3-yard line. Inside and back out, back up the numbers to the 21.
Overall, I don't know if I would have figured this game to be 9-9 with 11 minutes left to go in the first half. Both teams have played pretty well. And there haven't been too many turnovers or penalties.
Two wideouts right, two left. O'Sullivan, the quarterback, redshirt freshman, hands off. McShane runs into his offensive lineman, still makes a few miss, and he'll pick up eight on the carry. That was all Vance McShane there because that was blown up from the beginning. I believe Michael Johnson in there pushing his offensive lineman back into the running back. Second down and one now at the 30-yard line for the Cougars. McShane moves to the right of O'Sullivan. Pringle goes in motion to the backfield. No blitzing this time by the Saints. And Pringle is hit. He dives for the chains, but not sure he got there.
He's going to be short. I really like the way that defense here early in the first half is swarming to the football.
He did not get there. Third down and one. No gain. That was the wide receiver Pringle on the run. Opportunity here for St. Francis. Throw. That was a nice play call for the first down outside. Hit made by Rio Strama, the senior corner out of Joliet Catholic.
Simple, safe play, just a stop hitch on the outside, go 2 yards past the first down marker, turn and catch.
New set of downs for the Cougars here. Throwing. It's complete. It's a sprint at this point, and it's going to be a first down, a gain of about 14 yards on the play. Brandon Hickson, again, the freshman out of Harlem High School.
St. X has done a nice job of throwing outside the numbers, short, almost wide receiver type screen passes.
Pringle again in motion. Gonna fake it to him. O'Sullivan to throw. Looking long this time. Down the middle, and it is complete.
Nice play.
Nice job coming back for the ball is Luke Dill, and he'll turn up field for another eight more or so. And another Cougar first down.
He came back to the ball, caught the ball with his hands away from his body, turned it back up, and got enough for the first down.
Nine to nine. One turnover each, I believe, for each team. O'Sullivan to throw. Another quick pass outside. Another one caught and out of bounds. And pick up about three or four. And a flag coming in from behind the quarterback on the play.
And that could be a personal foul against us. Or hands to the face.
It's Max Briscoe, the freshman out of Joliet Catholic.
Roughing the passer.
Interesting call. Tack on 15 for the Cougars, and they're at the 20-yard line of St. Francis. 9-9, 8.5 to go, first half. Again, motion. They go to McShane on the reverse. He'll pick up, I don't know, 2 or 3 yards or so before he's forced out of bounds, second down.
Nice job at the point of attack by us defensively. Made him bounce it outside, and he could have got a lot more, but he only got 2 yards.
McShane again left of O'Sullivan. Receivers cross in the middle of the field. Plenty of time here for O'Sullivan. Their time is running out as he breaks out of the pocket, trying to find somebody, and he does inside the 10-yard line. But another flag comes in. Nice job by O'Sullivan by creating the time, and a great job by Hickson, the wide receiver, finding his quarterback and getting the ball. See what the penalty is. Another personal foul, another roughing the passer on St. Francis. Two in a row. I didn't see the play there. I guess I didn't see the penalty.
I didn't see the end of that play either, but anytime he breaks out of the pocket, he becomes a what? A running back. Correct? He becomes a running back.
Yeah, I'm not sure. Yeah.
Right? He becomes a running back.
In either case, it's going to be first and goal for the Cougars here at the 5. O'Sullivan, here comes the blitz by St. Francis. Checks it down to McShane. One man to beat, and he's kept out of the end zone there at the last minute. So it's going to be second down.
You're getting him at the 1 yard line.
Yep, Tom Willis there to deny him for the moment. 7:10 to go, first half. New offensive lineman coming in for St. Xavier. Look for them to go behind their big left tackle, Colin Cox, here. There's the snap, direct snap to McShane. Behind his offensive line, they fall forward. He looks like he's in. Oh, they're going to say he was stopped just shy. It's going to be third down and goal at the 1 foot line. He's always bothered me, though. There is no line. He's 1 foot away from the goal line. 6.5 to go in the first half. St. Xavier looking to break this 9-9 tie. O'Sullivan goes under center. Quarterback sneak. Flag comes in again, and they're just going to pile up on the goal line. I'm going to wave it dead. There is no indication for touchdown.
Is that going to be a legal procedure against St. X?
Officials will confer. Yes, it will. It's going to go against the Cougars, so it's going to move them off the goal line here on third down.
Coming back to about the 5.
Again, no fans in attendance today. You would have had to bring your own shovel as the snow remains piled up here on the bleachers.
Yeah, I thought I was climbing Mount Everest trying to get up to the press box today, and then Mr. Lakeda had to help me up the stairs, and I almost fell down like 10 times.
Third down and goal back at the 6-yard line now for St. Xavier. We're tied at 9. O'Sullivan to throw into the corner of the end zone, and it is intercepted by the Saints. Saints with their second takeaway of the game. This time, Rio Strama. He had one interception a year ago. He gets his first one of this season.
And that was just poor ball placement by O'Sullivan, because if you're going to throw a fade, you got to throw it to the back corner of the end zone to the far pylon. And it wasn't even the back shoulder fade, because he left that short too. And Rio had just a great leverage on that wide receiver. He threw the ball right to him.
Yeah, he left that one up there. And Rio Strama shows off the interception championship belt. It is yours for the time being, everybody. How about that? St. Xavier on the goal line, on the 1-foot line, denied by the Saints defense. When was the last time that happened?
Oh, and I had to go back.
Yeah.
That's the memory vault on that one.
Oh. That's communication. Maffey still has it. He's going to launch it downfield for Johnson, and a little bit too long and incomplete. Johnson couldn't quite get his footing underneath him.
Never got a handle on it. Throw a wounded duck down there. That ball's got to be like a rock.
Yeah. Trent Hudak coming off, going on, now coming back off. Parade Barberin back in the game on the right side of Maffey. Snap back to Eric, play action again, down the middle of the field and incomplete. He was well beyond his intended target. I thought he was going for Dan Getch there, and it was almost picked off.
It was a misread by both the wide receiver and the quarterback. He thought he was going to go up and carry that route further down the field. Receiver cut it off.
Six minutes to go in the half. 9-9 our score. Both teams with a touchdown and a field goal. Here comes the blitz, throwing, and it is caught. First down. Out of bounds at the 36-yard line. A pickup of 16 for the Saints. This time to Kamon Corin, the junior out of Los Angeles.
Does a nice job just staying in the pocket, knowing he's going to get punched in the face. Delivers that ball enough for a first down.
First down for the Saints. Barberin with the carry. Trying to carry a few Cougars with him, and he picks up a respectable 4 yards. 5.5 to go.
That's all you want. You don't need 11, 12 yards of play all the time. Give me my 3 or 4. Give me a manageable second down situations.
Second down at 6. Throwing again. Firing left side for Johnson again, overthrowing the receiver. All of Maffey's misses have been long so far today. Rayvon's going to trot off here on this third down play. Clock stopped at 5:06. Snap back to Maffey. Check it down to Perret. He's got a little room to turn it upfield.
Put your shoulder down.
Knocked forward for a first down.
He got it. I think with the tackle. Come from the – yeah, the line judge says first down.
Perret, not the most fleet of foot. His strength is strength if he puts that shoulder down, to your point there, Coach. But it is a first down up to the 49-yard line. Keenan Haley looking for a hole. He'll squeeze through to the 45-yard line and pick up six. Would you agree Keenan Haley the more effective back so far today?
He is, just because he's a little bit quicker at the point of attack. But one thing I like to see Mr. Haley do is hold that ball a little higher and tighter, because he gets a little looser with it when he's carrying it.
Maffey, quarterback keeper, nothing on the edge. And well, that wasn't Maffey, I apologize. That was Dan McLaren on the direct snap. He's going to stay in. No, he's not. And a Wildcat from St. Francis on the play. Didn't expect to see that. Third down now and four. Maffey will take his spot behind the line. Under 4 minutes to play in the first half. Blitz from St. Xavier. Maffey gets it off in time, and it's caught for a first down to the 35. The newcomer, Liam Eldridge, with the reception. Maffey took a shot there, but got it off just in time to move the chains for St. Francis.
Little in route. He had inside leverage, comes back to the ball, catches the ball, secures enough for the first down, covers up the football.
First down, the give, Haley. Behind the right side of that line, he's like that spot most of the day, and he'll pick up three up to the 31-yard line. Second down.
Plenty of time, 3:10 left to go in the half.
Motion is Hudak. They're going to give to Haley. Puts his shoulder down. Another interior run, and he'll pick up another three to the 27-yard line. It'll bring up third down and three.
You would think this would be four down territory. We'll see if they think so on this play.
Third down and three here for Eric Maffey and the St. Francis offense. Haley on his right hip again, Hudak in motion. They give it to Trent. He dropped the football, but he did jump on it. Never had control of it in the first place. It's going to go for no gain. Fourth down coming up. The freshman out of Minooka slipped right through his hands.
I would let this play clock run all down and call a timeout and make sure we're on the right play.
2:06 to play in the game. 22 seconds on the play clock. 9-9 the score. Coach Curry's explaining to the referee exactly what you explained to us. 7 on the play clock, 1:47 to go on the game clock. There's your timeout with 1:41. They're still letting the clock continues to wind. There we go. Oh, it's still going.
Yeah, I'm just saying, you know, the back judge right now is losing his mind because he's in charge of the on-field time.
Should be about 1:47 on that clock.
Yeah.
Or so.
Back judge says, no. He says, I got a 1:47.
St. Xavier's schedule looks like this. They got three road games to start the year after they're done here in Joliet. They'll take their trip to Davenport to take on St. Ambrose next week. And then up to Arlington Heights to take on Roosevelt. Actually, four games in a row to start. Four games on the road to start the season. Then they're going to be at Trinity International for week four. And then it's three home games, Roosevelt, Missouri Baptist, and St. Ambrose. They're going to finish up the year with Olivet down in Bourbonnais. And then again, they will host the Saints of St. Francis up on the south side to finish up the year. And again, this is only a conference game if that last game doesn't happen. So, put a star by it. Play it as if it is a conference game. Still waiting for the
clock.
Yep, they're going to put 41
on the clock.
There we go. Set to go. Fourth down, and the offense is on the field for the Saints. Corin, the running back. Blitz being shown by the Cougars. Let's see if they bring it or drop back. They're going to bring one extra guy. Play action. Matthew's going to keep it, and he picks up the first down by a yard. He needed four, and he picked up five. Eric Maffey. Quarterbacks have been known to run here for the Saints offense. And he did a great job there to move the chains. And quickly back to the line go the Saints. 1:30 to go in the first half. Hand off. Not going anywhere for Corin. He'll pick up a yard up to the 22. Going to be
injury timeout.
Nope, they got somebody down there in front of the St. Francis bench.
I can't see the number, but he came out holding his arm and his shoulder.
That's Dan Getch, and he injured that shoulder last quarter, I think, at this point. He's been fighting it the whole time. I don't think he can handle the pain quite anymore, and he's going to have to get that looked at.
I don't know if you've ever played in the cold, but if you get a shoulder, like a burner or a stinger or something on your elbow, you can't feel your whole arm. It just goes numb.
Four wideouts again. Corin on the left hip of Maffey. Second down and nine. Throwing. Out route. Incomplete. Looking for McLaren again. Same formation here for the Saints on third down and nine. We are under 1 minute to go. Clock stopped at 55 seconds. Hudak in motion. Play action on the jet sweep. Throwing, and it was tipped, so no pass interference and incomplete.
Too long for a field goal, but looks like they're trying out the field goal team.
Well, Made has the leg. I don't know if he has the leg when it's 13 degrees outside. We'll see if he's got it here. 39-yard attempt for Brian Made. He hit earlier from 34. Snap good. Hold down. Kick on the way. He's got to get there. Nope. Not today. Probably about 3-4 yards shy. We remain tied at 9 with 43 seconds to go. St. Xavier will take it over at the 22-yard line.
I am very impressed here in the first half with the energy that St. Francis has come out and played this first half with.
Yep. Waiting 448 days for this. That's how long it's been since the last St. Francis football game, which was against St. Xavier, which was here in Joliet back on November 16th of 2019. Quarterback keeper spinning, and down at the 29-yard line. Stuart Ross, the freshman quarterback. Pringle in motion for the Cougars. Play action there. Ross is going to throw. Plenty of time. Finds a target. He's wide open in the middle of the field before he's angled out of bounds at the 50-yard line. This time, Kyle Quinn with the reception. The freshman out of Lincoln Way East.
You have enough time if you're Saint X to run two plays and attempt a field goal if you complete both passes.
First down at midfield, 12 seconds on the clock. Check down to McShane. He'll go out of bounds at the 46 with 8 seconds to go.
There's one.
Send two safeties back now for St. Francis. A lot of defensive backs on the field. McShane, left hip of Ross. We've seen two quarterbacks for St. Xavier today. And hit from behind as he's thrown, but it's complete and out of bounds. He was hit hard as he completed that pass to McLaren, right square in the back, right between the numbers.
2.5 seconds left to go on the half. So you're going to have to attempt to throw this ball in the end zone.
The timeout called by the Cougars. It'll be third down and two with 2.5 seconds to go. I'd like to thank everyone joining us on the YouTube feed. I know we play this later on our Joliet local television network as well. So thanks to all the Saints fans. No matter how you're listening, how you're watching to this game, it's just nice to have football. Nice to be back and call some games here, even if we do have to wear masks in the press box. I'd wear 5 masks if it means we can play some football today.
I don't know if anybody would be able to hear you, but
well, it could be end up being better for everybody at that point, I think.
Could be a good thing, I'm just saying.
I was really excited to see Will Aki today. Will Aki is a true freshman out of Altoff Catholic High School, quarterback for St. Francis. And I know Coach Curry had nothing but great things to say about him as a leader, as a thrower of the football. Not quite as big as arm as Eric Maffey has, but they say Will's just a great decision maker, and he just constantly brought up his leadership ability, even as a freshman, calling out the upperclassmen during practice, things like that. But out with a bit of a knee injury today, so Maffey with the start. Third down, and here we go. Final seconds tick off the clock. Ross is tripped up, and a flag comes in at the very last second.
That'll be holding against St. Xavier, I believe.
Should take us to halftime here. Let's get the official call before we step aside. It will be holding. It's going to be declined, and that will be the end of the first half. Our score is 9-9. We've had touchdowns and field goals from both teams. A 56-yard run from Vance McShane. The touchdown for St. Xavier. It was a punt return touchdown for St. Francis that put them on the board. And they also exchanged field goals. 9-9, our halftime score. We're going to take us step aside here for just a few moments. Come back to you with our second half. You're listening and watching Saints football on the USF Sports TV network. 9-9, our halftime score as the clock ticks down as we start our second half here momentarily. You'll have to excuse the longer halftime, just giving the players and referees and game staff a bit more time to warm up, and our camera crew out here too. Thank you to them for braving the cold weather. My name's Nick Jakus. Lee Turnbow is here taking a look at some of these halftime numbers. The passing numbers for St. Xavier kind of pop out to me a little bit. A lot more passing than what we would have expected here today as well. What's popping out to you there, Coach?
Well, I think the one thing that's popping out to me is that St. Francis, we've only tried 20 rushing attempts in the first half for 61 yards. And St. Xavier is 24 for 141 yards on the ground. John O'Sullivan's 14 out of 17 in the weather conditions that we have today for 98 yards. And it just, Keenan Haley really surprised me in the first half. He carried the ball 8 times for 52 yards. One thing that's, you know, really sticks out to me watching this, even though we ran only 35 total plays for 106 yards, we've converted 5 out of 10 on third down.
There you go. There's the big number that's keeping St. Francis in it, even with the gaudy offensive numbers, given the weather conditions for St. Xavier. Third downs have been kind to St. Francis. They've been doing the work, especially on the ground. Big thanks to Kane and Haley on that. St. Francis will get the football to start our second half. We are tied at 9. Thanks to everyone joining us on our YouTube live feed. Thanks to everyone listening in on this on tape delay as well. Iturbe, short angled kick. Return will be from the 28-yard line. Scotty T returns
for a
touchdown and runs over the gunner up to the 43-yard line. St. Francis, decent field position to start the second half.
Does a nice job just putting down his shoulder and running over the guy.
So we've seen two quarterbacks for St. Xavier, just one so far today. Eric Maffey, Will Aki also, the true freshman on the roster, dealing with a knee. So Eric Maffey, who's been a reserve the last couple of years for St. Francis behind some great quarterbacks. Donnie and Aaron Ellis and Major Dedman last year. Now it's Eric's turn to see what he can do. Handoff goes to Pere Barberin in the first play up to the 45-yard line. He'll just pick up 2.
And you'd like to see the offensive line come out here and establish something moving forward here in the second half. I know we kind of piece it together. We've got a couple guys out with injury, but you got to sit there and control the line of scrimmage.
Thad Ampadu, the starting center, out with injury, so they had to shuffle up the offensive line a little bit for St. Francis. Maffey to throw across the middle, and incomplete. Dan Getch was behind Dan. He got his hands on it, couldn't reel it in. It's going to bring up third down and 9.
I'd like to come out here and get a first down on the opening series.
Eric Maffey, the sophomore out of Moline High School, out of Coal Valley. First start of his college career today. Same can be said for St. Xavier. John O'Sullivan, the redshirt freshman. Here is Eric. A little bit of time, has to hurry. Did not feel the pocket collapsing there. He had to get rid of that a lot sooner. And it cost his team 4 yards back to the 40-yard line.
Yeah, Jack Lemke down the seam if you want him from a trips formation on the far side. And the weather conditions, the temperature, talking to the camera guys at halftime, it dropped as soon as the game started.
Yeah, sure.
Sun's gone away, snow's moving in.
Well, that's the thing, right? Like, the temperature honestly has remained the same, but the sun goes away and it feels way colder. We got a wind chill temperature
that goes blocked.
Off of Madej, but Madej looks like he got hit as he kicked that football, but it goes. Well, they're going to say it was tipped. That's why there's not going to be a penalty. That ball was blocked, and it trickled out of bounds at the St. Francis 45.
It was partially blocked. We talked about this early in the first half. Special teams, that's the wild card in this football game because of the time or lack thereof that each team has had for special teams.
Now here comes either John O'Sullivan or Stuart Ross. We've seen them both. It's been mainly the redshirt freshman O'Sullivan, but it's going to be Stuart Ross to start off the second half for the Cougars. Honestly, he's looked very comfortable. He hasn't thrown it very many times, but it's looked good when he has. It's first down, play action to McShane. Stuart Ross, plenty of time, going long, wide open, and connects inside the 5-yard line. It is complete to Jacob Luneman, and it's going to be first and goal for the Cougars On a, what, a 50, we'll say 45-yard pass.
And he was out there wide open, got behind the cornerback. And it looked like one of those where he was so wide open he didn't want to drop it.
Quickly to the line go the Cougars. Another throw. He's going to have to hurry.
Nice play.
Running for his life, and down he goes. Chris Peters applying the pressure for the St. Francis defense.
Be big to hold him to a field goal here.
They had it down inside the 1 yard line earlier in the first half. Oop, St. Francis jump, free play here for the Cougars. They're going to launch it in the end zone and incomplete. I was saying St. Xavier had that ball, like I said, at the 1 yard line, but a couple great defensive stands and a big penalty on the Cougars kept them out of the end zone.
Now, if you go back to the first half, the Cougars had the ball on the 1 foot line and failed to cash that one in too in the first half.
If you judge by last year, the first half has not been kind to St. Francis. They've been outscored about 24-10 by average in the first half of the games last year. Now, you can't really judge too much about what goes on here today given the weather, but a decent first half. Here is Ross looking to quarterback. Run, and he picked up.
Oh, so it came out. The ball came out.
St. Francis has it, and there goes Chris Johnson, the linebacker, all the way to the 45. I did not see who forced the fumble, but it's Chris Johnson on the return up toward midfield. How about that? Again inside the five for St. Xavier, and again turned away. The turnover belt goes to Chris Johnson after the Rio Strama interception.
And I think, and we don't have replay today, I think it was Chris Peters from the backside, ripping that ball out. Ball popped up in the air. We got it. And it's Katie Barr the door the other way.
Another big defensive play for the Brown and Gold. Inside the 5 yard line. First down. Let's see if the offense can make something happen. Maffey throwing and incomplete, looking for the bubble screen on the outside to Rayvon Johnson. But pressure in the face of the quarterback, forcing an errant pass, second down. Second down. They're going to run it to Perret, see if he can make somebody miss. A couple Cougars wrap him up and take him down at the 48-yard line. Pick up three there for Perret, picking up the number on his jersey.
Huge momentum shift. You'd like to convert here on third down and keep this going.
Third down. Keeping the offense can stay on the field for a bit. Maffey looking. Fires down the middle
nice
of the field.
Catch!
And it was bobbled. And did he come down with it? No, it was knocked away at the last second. Trent Hudak, the true freshman from Minooka, couldn't quite hold on in between about three Cougar defenders. Fourth down.
You might think I'm crazy, but this might be a great time for a fake punt.
I think you're crazy. That's what I think. Vance McShane to return the punt. Brian Mede, the freshman kicker. High wobbler, angled right, and it's going to bounce out of bounds at about the 25-yard line.
And I'm just listening after that last defensive stop. We got the turnover, returned it. You know, I was used to watching baseball games usually, you know, with no fans in stands, and you can kind of hear what the players are saying back and forth.
Yep.
But it was like I was in the huddle with Coach Curry talking to the defense. I heard everything clear as a bell.
We'd also like to apologize for some language either from before or through this game since there's no fans in the stands. First down, it's O'Sullivan back as the quarterback for St. Xavier. Three linemen, three linebackers for St. Francis. Quick out right side, it is complete. Ludeman up to the 30, roll down, and after a pick of a 5, second down. Quickly to the line go the Cougars. Corners off the receivers. McShane the carry. He'll pick up three, third down and two.
You get the idea that both teams are still kind of trying to find themselves, kind of feeling out as to what works offensively and what doesn't.
Yep. Quarterback sneak coming up here for O'Sullivan with about 2 yards to go, and he's going to pick it up this time. Last time this happened, he let the football go, but not this time. He picks up five on the quarterback keeper. First down for the Cougars, moving the chains. We're still tied at nine. 11 minutes to go here. Third quarter just underway in the second half. 22nd all-time meeting between the Cougars and the Saints. That is second only to the number of games against Olivet Nazarene. Pump fake. Looking long. Plenty of time. Wide open. Caught at the 45-yard line. Makes one man miss, but not the second, as he's chopped down right there at the 45. Tackle made by Scott T. Tumulty. I just can't say it, and I apologize. Tumulty. Is that it? We're going to go with it.
His mom and dad not going to be calling
me. I am so sorry to his family. I'll do better next time, I promise. Reception made by Hickson, by the way, for the Cougars. Here's Pringle in motion. Another check down, McShane. Plenty of grass in front of him on first down. I'm going to put him out at the 41-yard line, so he'll be 5 yards shy. Second down and five for the Cougars into St. Francis territory. Again in the shotgun, it is O'Sullivan looking right, and it's incomplete. Dangerous. It looked like Pringle tripped a little bit on that play, and the sailed past him over his right shoulder. Incomplete. Third down and five.
Supposed to be snow moving in later. It hasn't started yet. You can see the gray clouds moving in. A third and six call. Something outside the numbers to one of the wide receivers, I would think.
It's been the go-to play pretty much all game long. Let's see if they go to it again here. O'Sullivan, looks like they're going to change the play here.
And St. Francis showing.
Here for St. Xavier. Assistant coach of the year, batted at the line and incomplete. I think that was Tumulty again. He's emerged as quite the defender here for St. Francis. That could have been Chris Peters, too. Leapt up and knocked that ball out of the air. That brings up fourth down and six, and St. Xavier's punt team on. Another nice stand by the Saints defense. 9-9 here in the third quarter. 9:50 to go. I apologize, we don't have the score on the screen like we usually do, or replays, and that's because of the weather today. Some of the equipment literally freezing up. Punt is away.
Good punt.
Nice spiral, fair catch called for and made at the 8-yard line.
Overall, I'd have to say the play has been better than I would have expected for a first game coming off of 2 weeks of preseason.
Agreed. With a lot of new offensive skill guys, and you can tell the offense is going to need a lot of time to come together. But I like where the defense is at. But again, really hard to judge anything when on your first game after a 448-day layoff and 13-degree temperatures. Maffey here on first down. It's Keenan Haley on the carry. You've seen that play all day long. Right between the right tackle and right guard. Keenan Haley picks up another five, and it's been going. I mean, he's picked up four or five yards of crap.
He's consistent. He ran for 52 yards in the first half.
Motion for Hudak, fake to him, but the pressure's there by the Cougars. Down goes Maffey. He'll lose two. Third down and eight.
They list Keenan Haley as 5'10", 195 pounds. There's no way in heck that guy weighs 195 pounds.
Yeah, might be adding a few. No motion this time. Four receivers. Blitz and in the air, and it's intercepted by the Cougars at the 19. Ball was batted in the air, and it fell right into the hands of Peyton Nigro, the linebacker from Mokena.
Classic tip drill.
Yep.
A little bit too high. Ball's up in the air in the middle of the field. Comes over, picks it off. St. Francis defense needs another big-time stop. Is it too much to ask them to do it for the third time in the first half? They had the ball. St. X had the ball down on the one-foot line, didn't convert. And we got a big turnover last time they were down here.
8:36 to go, third quarter. We're tied at 9. O'Sullivan, the quarterback. McShane left, Smith to his right. Three wide receivers they give to McShane. He fakes the pitch, keeps it himself, looking for the edge, and funneled out of bounds at the 16-yard line. He'll pick up two or three on the play. Nice job in pursuit defensively for St. Francis.
And also, it's a nice job stringing out by the cornerback there, not allowing him to get upside the corner down the sideline.
Same formation for St. Francis. Two running backs. Smith right, McShane left for O'Sullivan. Second down and 8. Plenty of time in the pocket. Finds the crossing man, Ludeman. He'll pick up a first down. It's going to be first and goal for the Cougars. I'm going to put it at the 7-yard line.
You can only ask your defense to do so much.
See if St. Francis can get some pressure here. They give to McShane.
Oh, nice play.
Yep, right at the point of attack as he's taken down.
Because O'Sullivan doesn't strike you as a running threat, you're not going to really honor any RPO coming out the backside. His defensive end just crashes down, takes on the running back from the backside.
Blake Evans, Mike Johnson there on the tandem tackle. Second down and goal, back to the 9.5-yard line. O'Sullivan throwing, out route, caught at the 6, spinning, but help is there, and that's where it'll stay. Pick up a 4. Clock will continue to roll. 7:08 to go. We're still tied at 9. St. Xavier again into the red zone, but St. Francis red zone defense has been tough. St. Xavier just 1-for-3 in the red zone today. This is their 4th trip. Fake to McShane. It's going to be O'Sullivan on the carry, but he'll be tracked down at about the 8-yard line. He'll go backward on the play, and there to pump his fist at the end is the sophomore from IC Catholic, Mike Johnson.
Does a nice job of pursuing. Again, we said that you're not going to sit there and honor anything that O'Sullivan does with the ball in his hands as a runner because he doesn't have that breakaway speed or he's not real quick.
Again, they stand tough, and here comes the field goal unit for St. Xavier, the ever-reliable Mike Iturbe. For the 25-yard field goal. Plenty of leg. Looks good from here, and it is. Field goal gives the Cougars the lead. It's 12-9. Very reminiscent. A little bit higher scoring, but very reminiscent of the type of game I imagine you watched out of Lamont High School back in 91.
You couldn't watch because your eyes were frozen shut.
Yeah, that was the coldest game in USF history. Today is the second coldest, but only about 7 degrees of wind chill. It was 6 below 0 wind chill back in that game against Northwood from Michigan. Today it's 1 degree. The wind chill at kickoff, and I don't imagine it's changed much. Thankfully, the wind has not been very strong.
No, the wind has not been a factor here.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
I'm just checking. And in Joliet right now, it lists the temperature at 15 degrees.
That's up 2 degrees from kickoff.
I don't think it's 15 degrees. I'm just saying.
Let's ask our cameraman, does it feel like 15 degrees outside? They can't move. They're literally frozen, I think.
I think he said it feels more like 1, and it was with a certain finger, I think he was showing you.
1 degree. It's 12-9. 6:08 to go in the third quarter. Another close game between the Cougars and the Saints. Last time they played, last game of 2019 was a close game. St. Francis was A two-point conversion shy of sending it into overtime with 20 seconds left to go in the game. St. Xavier's defense held strong for the win in that one. It was a great game to finish the year. Little did we know back then that'd be the last game for a while. Here's the return. Scotty T, again, he's been dynamic defensively and in the special teams, in the special teams unit. A nice return up to the 30-yard line.
You expect you'd see a big dose of Haley here, wouldn't you? I mean, he's been our most effective runner so far. Yeah, and he's trotting back out there to go in the huddle.
It'll be Haley along with Maffey in the backfield. Dan Getch wide right. Looks like Ravon Johnson slot right. Four down linemen for the Cougars. They're only going to rush four, screen it out to the right side. If you can get a blocker, breaks one tackle, but not the second, up to the 32-yard line. That was Liam Eldridge, the transfer from Saddleback College out in Colorado. Tackle made for St. Xavier by Danny Sirocco, the senior out of Plainfield North. And just like the defense for St. Francis, St. Xavier's defense is pretty loaded as well. Pretty much everyone coming back this year that was on that squad last year that was third best in allowing points in the MSFA last year. Out left side, there's Johnson caught, but he's tackled immediately. Peyton Nigro, the outside linebacker again.
Third and eight.
And the offense from St. Xavier last year, obviously just putting up some pretty insane numbers, especially through the air with Alex Martinez. They're going to have to retool a little bit on offense, too. Here comes the blitz on third down. Maffey steps up, lets it rip left down the left sideline, and it's incomplete. Again, missing him just a bit long. Fourth down for St. Francis, and on comes Madej to kick it away.
And let's look at this the next time the Saints had the ball. They have, because of shuffling on the offensive line, they have moved Derek Wentworth into right guard position, and he had just been dominating his man. So if you want to make that adjustment and run behind Wentworth, all right, with Haley, and that's what Wentworth's on the sideline. He's talking to the coach. He says, I got my guy all day long.
High snap. Madej had to hurry to get that one off. Nice
punt.
High punt this time, sending the return man McShane back to the 30. It's a good 40-yard punt in 15-degree weather. 40 yards in the air. If anything, that drive at least gave the defense a bit of a break.
If they couldn't get it across midfield. They played outstanding football here in 2.5 quarters.
First down for the Cougars, and it's still John O'Sullivan. We've seen Stuart Ross at times, but it's probably been about 80%, 20% Sullivan. Blitz being shown by St. Francis. They'll bring a couple extra guys, and they get to him.
Yeah,
O'Sullivan wrapped up, and Blake Evans will finish it off. But Scotty T again. Scotty putting the pressure on the safety blitz.
And I thought they were going to get a call for hitting him in the helmet, but they didn't.
Yeah, that was real close. They will lose about 10. Actually, the 8. So second down and 18 for the Cougars. I love the new defense here for St. Francis. Same guys, but new scheme. Here's O'Sullivan down the middle and knocked away. Guess who knocked that one away again? Unbelievable. He's having a game. It's his coming out party today.
He's like a football magnet. He really is.
Scott Chimilty, the freshman safety, transfer from Augustana College, a Villa Park guy, somewhat local. And he is playing some defense today and special teams. Third down and 18 for the Cougars. Five defensive backs for the Saints. Looking, looking, looking. Here's pressure. Peters there first. Johnson there to finish it off. They continue to go backward.
Do you put the punt block on right now?
Let me correct myself. Cam Holman, I believe, putting the pressure on. Unbelievable defensive stand again. And now let me correct myself. It's Hassert, the punter, on to punt it away from about 8 yards into his own end zone. Scott Tumulty, he's returned the punt already for a touchdown, and he's standing at the St. Xavier 40. Kick away and sends Scotty back, and he will try to return it from the 41, hit immediately. Nice coverage by St. Xavier. Ron Carroll there along with Colin Steelman, special teams for St. Xavier.
Let's see where Derek Wentworth lines up, because I'm interested to see if he's still at the right guard position. If he is, I would take and then feature him as my lead block and run the ball behind him.
How about this, Scott? Again, Tumulty, I apologize for not getting his name right, but he wasn't even supposed to start today. He's only starting today because of an injury to Hathon Hurdle. First down and 10. It is Hudak on the jet sweep. Not too much gas on that play as he gets to about the 40-yard line. He'll pick up two. Did you see how hard he squeezed that ball? Mm-hmm. Last time they ran that play, he put it on the ground. Quickly to the line. Tight end right side is Getz. They're going to hand it off. Another carry for Corin, junior running back. St. Francis has had four players with a carry in the game. Keenan Haley, Kamon Corin, Pierre Perret-Barberin, and Eric Maffey. It's Corin back there right now. Third down and 5 for the Saints. Going to pass. Right. He has a man. It is Corin out of the backfield and tripped up inside the 5. He couldn't quite string it out. A turf monster got him there at the 5-yard line. It'll be first and goal for St. Francis.
Because of the weather, the ball comes out of your hand like a rock. It was a floater down the sideline. It must be very difficult for him to grip it. But a nice connection down the right sideline. Saints knocking on the door.
Perret-Barberin in at running back. They give to Perret, head down, but he can't quite get there. He'll be a yard or two shy, put him down at the 2. First and goal at the 2-yard line for St. Francis, looking for their first offensive touchdown. Their touchdown today came on a punt return. Maffey takes a snap to give to Barberin, but again he's there. Nigro on the stop from the linebacker position. Third down and goal back to the 5. Oh, now it's decision time, coach. Same personnel on the field for St. Francis. Hurry up offense. Look for Ravon Johnson. He's slot left if they want to throw it. Nope. Yeah, it's a play action. Maffey going to keep it. Still on his feet. Still fighting. Cornerback inside the 5 to the 3. He will be denied. It's going to be fourth and goal for St. Francis at the 4. They mark him down at.
Going to be at the 3 officially.
Okay.
And let's see. Boy, you got a under a minute left.
Yep. Under a minute left. It's 12-9, St. Xavier.
Looks like they're going to take the timeout and talk about this.
Matt McCarthy, the offensive coordinator, up here in the booth calling the plays. If you were the offensive coordinator here, you've been stuffed 3 times on the carries. What do you like to do here on fourth down? How about just kick it, tie the game, or are you going to try to score a touchdown?
Well, this tells me they're going to go for it because they want to take the timeout, burn it, and kick it to tie it. So right now you're deciding what your best play is. Either way, if you go for it and you don't convert, then the Cougars had the ball on the 3-yard line moving out, and you trust in your defense.
Maybe I'm just too conservative of a guy, but I kick it just to tie it here, but see what they do. Next game for St. Francis next week at home here at the field. Hopefully get rid of some of this snow. It's going to be against Roosevelt University combining with Robert Morris. That's
what are they calling them? What's the nickname of
the Lakers?
Okay.
Roosevelt Lakers. Yep.
Okay. I just want to make sure.
Next week at 1:00. Kickoff here at 1:00. St. Xavier on the road again. They start the season with four road games. Next week they're going to be out in Davenport to take on St. Ambrose, who is also playing today. They kick off at 3 o'clock.
That's a good call.
Against Roosevelt.
As the snow begins to trickle
there
down.
There comes the snow, yep. And they will go for it. Offense on the field here for the Brown and Gold. Maffey, the quarterback in the shotgun. Parade Barberin on his left hip. Here we go. They are not interested in the tie. They want to take the lead. There's the snap. They want to throw. Maffey into the end zone. Picked. They tried to force that play into Liam Eldridge. They tried to get him into the corner, but he was jammed at the line, and the timing of the play was off from the beginning.
You have to credit the Cougar defense, who was playing solid.
That defense for the Cougars did not give an inch once that ball was inside the red zone.
And the other
they
thing
were
that,
tough.
The other thing that does with the interception in the end zone, now instead of having the ball on the three coming out, they get the ball at the 20 moving out.
Yep. 33 seconds to go here in the third quarter, by the way. It's 12-9. Cougars by a field goal. St. Francis showing blitz here on first down and 10. It's O'Sullivan, the quarterback, changing the play. See how many they bring. Almost everybody. They get it out, though. Ooh, bobbled but caught by the receiver, Pringle.
There's a flag because there's a offensive lineman about 15 yards down the line, downfield.
Yeah, when you see somebody in their 70s out near the first down marker.
I don't think 78 was an eligible receiver on that play. I'm just saying.
They're going to wave the penalty off. Inadvertent flag, so the end of the play was a 3-yard reception for Pringle.
That was a pass play, right?
It was a pass play.
There was an offensive lineman, 78, 10 yards down the field.
And St. Francis going to stack everyone in the box there. O'Sullivan to throw. Wide open again in the middle of the field and a first down for the Cougars out to the 40-yard line. Goes for about 16 yards to Quay Thompson. Final seconds of the third quarter ticking off here. And I think St. Xavier is content to let it do just that. That's the end of quarter number three. It is 12-9 here at the frozen tundra of Joliet Memorial Stadium. We'll get some third quarter stats here momentarily. Like we said, we are in an active winter weather advisory, by the way, not just because of the cold, but because of the snow that has begun to fall.
Well, you're just full of good news today, aren't you?
Hey, you know what? I just report the facts here, Coach. How about this? I was taking a look, just doing a bit of research on who sealed off that edge. Is that Peters or is that Holman?